Hey, what is up? Please forgive me for not being on YouTube for a while, but I'm glad to be back on YouTube. And this video's theme is dreams. And I know it sounds cliche when people say follow your dreams or chase your dreams, but there's a reason behind that. There's a reason why it's cliche. Stay tuned for the whole video so not only you'll know why it's a cliche, but you can be woke. I'm gonna cut to the chase. Dreams are something that you would wanna capture and write down as much as you can because they're the realest, the purest forms of yourself. Because in this real life or outside world, however you want to call it, there's a lot of outside forces that define you that isn't really naturally you. If you think about it, do you really like going to school? Is that really you? Do you really like that 9-to-5 even though you have to pay your bills? But is that really you? But when you sleep, that's when you're relaxed. The purest thoughts come out into your vision and you can see what you can do, what makes you happy, what makes you scared, and all other beautiful emotions that are natural. Those things you gotta remember, but dreams are so easy to forget. So that's why it's very important to write it down. And this is what I did. Here, I have a sticky note and a pen, and here it goes. Boom, all right, write it down because it's important. The reason why in this world, dreams is a negative connotation is so they can keep you away from being the highest version of yourself. And whether that dreams are ambitions or just basic thoughts or symbolic thoughts, it's symbolism. And symbolism is what drives ambition, what drives a person to be the highest version of themselves. And that's why it's a cliche, because it keeps you away, because no one likes something cheesy. But so if they make it cheesy, less and less people would wanna engage in it. No, engage in it, chase it, because then that's where you can be someone unique, be you. There's a reason why a lot of haters don't want you to follow your dreams and they end up stigmatizing you by laughing at you or taking you as a joke, because they want you to stay at your 9-to-5. They want you to stay at your stressful college hours. Yes, when people say follow your dreams is something symbolic, but there's symbolism to it. But not only you gotta follow it, because there's other woke people like you, and that's why you gotta chase for it. You gotta hustle for your dreams. They'll make it cheesy, right? So you don't do it. But as soon as you do it, you get joked on because they don't want you to be the highest version of you. That's why you gotta really respect the ones who support you being the highest version of you, because no one likes it when you change, because change is something so big in one person's feelings. In the psychological mind, everyone wants you to stay the same because it's convenient in their mind. But as soon as you change for the betterment of yourself, people will start to laugh at you, call you cocky, all these negative things behind your back because they just don't like it. But you gotta not worry about that and just engage it, because like, hey, I've changed after high school and some people think that I'm arrogant, but that's okay. I'm gonna be with people that will truly support who I wanna be and who I believe that I am meant to be. Bonus, if you can put your ambition and your thoughts of symbolism together, and then that's where you can truly be the highest version of yourself. So yeah, let me ask you this. If you go to school, right? You're told to do so, right? You don't dream about, oh, I love going to school. You don't tell yourself that. Unless you're destined to be a valedictorian, then that's a different story. And there's some people who are happy with a 9-to-5, and there's nothing wrong with that. But for my friends who are not meant to be a 9-to-5 person, do you really see yourself happy as you sleep? No, you think of yourself doing something else. Because when you sleep, that's where your natural spiritual mind, the soul, channels something that is the most organic version of you. And that's why it's important for you to write it down. You know what I'm saying? This real life matrix is trying to keep you away from being the best version of you. And it's trying to keep you average. That's why they make your chase your dreams cheesy. But then as soon as you cross that line, then you get stigmatized. And that's when you gotta work harder. That's when the stage of you changing will make people irritated. And then that's when they start calling you names behind your back. And then you're just gonna have to keep pushing for it even more, being a motherfucking hustler. And then you fight and fight, and then that's where you start to be the best version of you. So the best way to do it is to sleep, dream it, write it down, plan, and fight and fight. Don't worry about the stigmatization. In fact, engage in the stigmatization. Go through it, because the thing is, if there's no stigmatization against you, then you're doing something wrong. You gotta be disliked. You gotta be hated. All right? So that's what I'm trying to tell you all. Don't be a basic person. If you know that you're not meant to be basic, then get out there. Get out there. get dirty, get muddy, because it's time to get real. It's time for you to be the best version of you. Be the king or queen that you were meant to be. All right, okay, cool. All right, promise me. Don't be afraid. Chase and hustle for your motherfucking dreams. Hey everyone, if you found this video motivational, then please give it a like. If you're new to this channel, then please subscribe so you can get some more woke videos so you can be the best version of you. And if you think this video can help a friend out, then please share this video. If you have any questions or concerns or thoughts, please comment that down below. Otherwise, I'm gonna hustle for my dreams. Peace. Let's go.